We already talked about this part here, so why our electromagnetic emission that you can see here is somehow jumping up here at a certain frequency. So this frequency is 30 megahertz. Just to repeat what we have learned last time, we said that based on international standards, we have to measure in frequency ranges. CISPA 16 frequency ranges, for example. And there is range B and range C that is seen here. So our range B goes from 150 kilohertz up to 30 megahertz. And then from 30 megahertz to 1 gigahertz, we have the range C. And in these frequency ranges, we have to use different resolution bandwidths of our EMI receiver. Who remembers what is the resolution bandwidth in the lower frequency range? And what's the resolution bandwidth in the higher frequency range? Ah, these are typical questions for the final exam.
120 kilohertz in the higher.
Okay, 120 kilohertz in the higher frequency range, yeah, from 30 megahertz to 1 gigahertz. And what was the resolution bandwidth in the lower frequency? 9 kilohertz, exactly. This is the resolution bandwidth when we are using an EMI receiver. For these measurements, we can also use a spectrum analyzer. But usually, a spectrum analyzer has resolution bandwidths that are a little bit different than the resolution bandwidths of the EMI receiver. So if you're using a spectrum analyzer, don't worry. But in this frequency range, you will set an input resolution bandwidth filter of 10 kilohertz and here of 100 kilohertz. Okay, so 9 kilohertz to 120, 10 kilohertz to 100. So it's not a very big difference. But as the resolution bandwidth in the higher frequency range is bigger, also more noise, for example, can get into the input. So therefore, also the noise floor is shifted by a certain degree, by a certain amount of decibels. 120 divided by 9 logarithmic, and then 20 times the thing is then the offset that we have. Okay, so we already talked about why we have this step here. And I think we stopped somewhere here explaining what's the difference between this characteristic here that falls down and the characteristic of the small peaks that are ranging out of our electromagnetic emission that is caused by the switching activity. I also told you a little bit about the TUT, our device under test. I said it's an automotive product, for example, an automotive high side switch. We also talked about what is a high side switch and why we need a so-called charge pump inside of the high side switch, especially if the power MOSFET that is used inside is a N-channel MOSFET. So it is also important to understand why we have to use a charge pump. And we said that there are typically two noise sources in our device on the desk. One is the device on the desk itself by switching on and switching off. Here we said that we are switching at a certain frequency of 100 hertz, which is very often used in automotive, for example, to turn the front lights on and off. So there we are turning the lights in a PWM mode on and off with 100 hertz, for example. And the second source is the internal switching activity of the charge pump. Taking a look at this diagram, what do you think is the internal switching frequency of the charge pump? This can be directly seen out of the diagram. Any idea? Yeah. Well, here it's difficult to say if there is a noise peak from the charge pump below the switching activity peak, but the first one that can be really seen is here at 2.3 megahertz. And then we usually should see all the harmonics. Yeah. And for this device, the internal switching frequency of the charge pump is in the range of 2.5 megahertz. Okay, so we stopped here at differentiating between narrowband emission and broadband emission. And now we have to define what is broadband and what is narrowband. Usually the standard says that, I have an input filter with a certain filtering bandwidth, 9 kHz. Very often it's a kind of Gaussian-shaped filter. And if there are spectral components falling in this resolution bandwidth, for example, the 100 Hz switching harmonics, so I have my fundamental frequency, 100 Hz, 200 Hz, 300 Hz, 400 Hz, and so on. How many spectral components are within the 9 kHz bandwidth if I have a switching activity or a switching frequency of 100 Hz? Resolution bandwidth is a Gaussian filter of 9 kHz. Okay. So everything that you can see here is the broadband emission from the 100 Hz switching frequency. And here we have the first narrowband contribution here and here and here. And here comes then the mixture between broadband and narrowband.